Mr. Speaker, I'm here to say a few words just to reemphasize the importance of House Resolution 642. And some of it will be repetitive, as Representative McNeil spoke on this subject. But I think it's important not only to stress what has already been said, but to add a few additional remarks. Sexually assaulted in the early morning hours on her 42nd birthday, one of our own, Shannon Keith, and I do have permission to use her name. She was assaulted, and as she, after the traumatic event, she shared this with some of her friends, one included myself. She was sexually assaulted in the early morning hours of her 42nd birthday. She explained how frustrating the past few months had been, likening it to a feeling of being re-victimized by a broken system. And I'd like to emphasize the words broken system. Like many attempting to recover from sexual trauma, she has struggled with depression, anxiety, and post-traumatic stress disorder. And admittedly, also part of the 1 out of 10 of survivors contemplated, attempted, or died by suicide, a sad and direct reflection of the shortcomings of our current approach in supporting these vulnerable Pennsylvanians. I might add, her experience motivated House Resolution 642, which calls for the Joint State Government Commission to conduct a study to determine ways in which we could do better to connect survivors of sexual assault and rape to mental health services. From college campuses, places of worship, and workplaces, no community is left untouched by these pervasive epidemic. I intend on asking the governor in a written request, since we have one of our own who experienced this traumatic experience, I will ask the governor to sit down with this individual so that he may hear her personal report on what happened to her and what happened as she sought assistance in trying to deal with this problem. We just simply have to do better, and hopefully House Resolution 642, which is a study of sexual assault and mental health, will do that. We must be more consistent and reliable in dealing with these problems, and I would sincerely hope that the governor and this study will reveal and predict and provide better services to those individuals who experience these traumatic experiences. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.